had rooms up on the top floor.
And every one of the boys had their own room. They could do anything they wanted to, or whatever they did in that fourth floor, third floor. Imagine.
Happy birthday.
But this garage at our house in Yonkers had three stories. Can you imagine a three-story garage? And on the bottom floor, the basement floor of the garage, was where they kept their horses. On the main floor, where you normally have a garage, is where they kept the carriages for the horses.
Yeah.
And on the third floor, they had rooms. And every one of those rooms, I'm sure at one point they probably were used for some of the help. But when my grandfather lived there, one of his sons had a room. So my father had his own room, his brothers all had their own. But each of the boys that had their rooms, whatever they did in that room became very famous. But my father used his room to develop ham radio. So he has some stories that won't quit. What he discovered when he, in ham radio, the first sinking of the whatever boat, ship, the Lusitania, out there, he discovered, he learned all those things. But what was most interesting about it was when he met my mother, he went to his father was a publisher, book publisher. My mother's father was a book publisher in Chicago. And they met at a book publishing convention. Did I tell you this story before?
No, I don't think so.
But my father saw my mother. She really was beautiful. We don't look like her, so she was magnificent. And he went up to her and he says, I'm going to marry you. And she said, oh, that's ridiculous. You're not going to marry. 4 months later, they were married. But he said, I want to take you around the world. Well, that was back in the 20s.
The 20s.
And there wasn't such thing as going around the world.
So 1922.
So he said, but I want to take you around the
world. Didn't leave the
on a ship. On a ship. He couldn't fly. So he said, she said, you can't afford to take me around the world. He said, I will. So what he did was he went to the New York newspaper and he said, I tell you what, he said, I'm a ham radio operator. I will radio my story every day that we're on this trip.
Through Morse code.
Every day.
So
that's how he paid for his trip around the world for his honeymoon, by radioing these things. And
he had to use Morse code, didn't he? He had to send him a Morse code.
Yes. Yeah. And somewhere, I think I have some of those stories that he wrote.
I've got it. I've got that book of all his stories that he wrote. Every time they entered a different city, he typed up a story about that particular country and city and sent it back to the New York Times through the radio by Morse code.
That's
and they published.
That's how he paid for his trip around the world with his...
Wow.
How did you get that book?
Nobody even
Randall, how did you get that?
You tell me that. I remember this.
But how did you get that book? I've never seen it.
Oh, I have a copy of it.
I don't have a copy.
Okay, I'll scan it.
How long would that have taken?
How long was the trip around the world?
Probably a month.
Much longer.
Well, 2 months maybe.
It was
probably 3 months.
But can you imagine? Like that was in the early 1900s.
The steamers didn't even go 12 miles an hour back then.
But he had some very interesting stories when he was using his. You don't have his. Do you have his computer?
I have his radio. I had his radio. I don't know.
Okay, these are muscles. Have you ever had a muscle?